is correct. No. There's no such thing as 100% correct truth. No. Okay, so that's why when we report our findings, we have to use hedging. You have to soften the tone. You want to say that you are correct, but you need to soften it. You need to balance. You need to water it down a bit by using these modal verbs like this could be because. You know what I mean? So after the treatment, you know, students were found to speak English more fluently. This could be because. Don't say that is because. Okay, so you say you use could be. Okay? And then another example, it may have been due to. So when you say it may have been, you are distancing a little bit back, right? Okay. And then the reason might be, the reason could be. Okay? So that's what we mean by cool-headed, okay, sober, reason, balance kind of writing. Okay? And then any researcher has to be mindful about keeping your bibliography, okay? Keep it running on your laptop, whatever you save them, okay? And then time frame, what's your time frame, okay? Things like that. Okay, so I don't need to carry on after this slide, because okay? I already spoken for about an hour now, yeah? And you are not sleeping yet. That's amazing. Okay, so now I want to draw your attention to, because you just been given three handouts, right?
Two handouts.
Do you have this little thing with this photo in the corner? Not yet? Because I want to use it now. With a photograph. So I am taking it out from one of the textbooks that I'm currently using now with my research writing class. Okay, so now this part, all the students, right? And here, okay, the other side.
Cheers.
So, if you think that you are a student here, I'd like you to participate. Okay, so please try to take part in and try to answer the question. Okay. So, looking at the first page. So from now on, the mode, okay, the style of the delivery of the lesson will be a bit more like workshop in the classroom. Okay? So I come to you and then I might want to hear something from you, okay, after my question. Okay, so can we look at number three, thinking critical? Yeah. Okay. Thinking critical. In your database studies, writers and lecturers will often present you with arguments trying to persuade you to accept certain ideas by giving reasons why you should. Okay. Critical thinking involves judging these arguments, that is, deciding whether to accept them. So what I want you to do now is, I want you to read the paragraph, starting with the majority of people. See that paragraph? Okay. So can you please read it two times, quietly. Read it internally, quietly, two times. And read carefully, and think.
Behavior is worse than can be found in the broken and disciplined schools in recent years. Along with the family environment, school is an important influence on how a child develops. It follows, therefore, that it is only by improving discipline in schools that we can't solve this defined externalness of behavior.
Thank you very much. Beautiful voice, very clear reading. You could be an MC in my next wedding. If I plan to do it again in the future. Okay, good. Now, my question is, look at this paragraph. If you are a superficial reader, if you read casually, carelessly, you might tend to agree with the argument. You might tend to agree with this writer's opinion. You might be persuaded to believe what he is arguing. Okay? But my question is, are you persuaded? Do you agree with the writer's opinion? After reading this short paragraph, are you convinced? Do you believe what he's presenting? We're talking about research writing. We are talking about academic writing. And remember the very first point I presented to you this morning? Evidence. Academic writing is evidenced. So, now I want you to criticize, to make some comments. Are you persuaded? Do you agree with this writer's opinion? His argument, yes or no? If you're the supervisor, if you're the professor, would you pass this student based on this writer? What do you feel, what do you think is missing? There's no concrete evidence. Evidence like what? Now you see I'm a difficult teacher, right? You give me an answer, I give you another question. Yeah, so there's no evidence. What kind of evidence do you need to see? Breakdown in student discipline. Look at the beginning. The majority of people. So when I read a writing like this, my question is, which people? Okay. Which subjects? Who are you talking about? Yeah, so it has to be clear. Right? And then, Second line. In the past. So my question is, when? Which year? How long ago? Are you talking about 10 years ago? Are you talking about 19th century? Right? It's not clear. Yeah, so that's what you said next slide. Breakdown in discipline in school, right? And then you look at the second line from the bottom. Second line from the bottom. Look at this sentence. It follows, therefore, that it is only by. So I am really disappointed here. You are telling me only by. No, don't do that. Right? So you're saying that me, that's me, the other, or correct. Incorrect. Yeah? So that's a very quick exercise to show you. Are you a critical reader? Okay. And if the writing lacks evidence, can you detect? Can you notice? Now you can. So very happy. So let's move on. Number four. Point four. Avoiding plagiarism. Okay. Can somebody please define plagiarism?
Copying.
Okay. Copying what? Copying the other person's writing without giving. I'm looking for a word starting with C.
Credit.
Okay? So we have to give credit to the original author, right? So if you don't mention it in your reference, if you don't give credit and you pretend it like your own writing, this is stealing. That's why the noun plagiarism goes with the verb commit, like a crime. Okay? Student was expelled from the university because he committed plagiarism. He plagiarized. Okay? So we have to avoid plagiarism. So that's the focus of the next exercise. I want you to read the next paragraph at the bottom of the page, which is taken out from original, okay, book. And then on the next page, second page, on top, I want you to read the student's writing. And after you compare these two different paragraphs, the original and the student's writing, I want you to tell me if the student is guilty of plagiarism. Yes or no? So I give you 5 minutes. You have to be very alert, you have to be very prepared, because what you are doing now is you are doing a police job. You are trying to catch the thief. Did he steal or not? Is he a thief or not? You have to use your judgment. Lifted from that book, use the word lift. We don't say you steal it, we don't say you copy. Doesn't sound good, right? We use euphemism, lift. Sounds polite, but the same steal it. Yeah. Okay, so the first 6 lines are almost entirely lifted from the original text. Okay? And after that, starting from a second effect is no. Okay. So starting from that line, I find the student try to change the wording a bit. Yeah? So it's not completely lifting. He took the idea and he used some of his own words. Yeah? What do we call it doing that? Paraphrasing. Yeah? So at the end of the paragraph, you see the reference. Right? So the writer acknowledged it's taken from this original source. So it looks like you are not stealing, but you are stealing by 60%, 70% in the beginning, right? So then for this kind of writing, how can we improve on it? How can we fix it? One thing is what we call paraphrasing, right? So you have to check the phrases, expression, vocabulary, right? Take only the idea and then rewrite it in your own words, paraphrasing. And another thing we can do is punctuation marks. What kind of punctuation marks? Quotes. Okay? So take a phrase, take a quote, and put it in quotation marks. Okay? And then you also give the reference at the end. So then that's good, that's better. Right? Okay. So this is about plagiarism. Okay, number 5. I think we can stop after this number 5. Now, I can see all of your eyes brighten up. Right, this is completion mark. Okay, so number 5. Recognizing variation across academic subjects. Are you familiar with the word discipline?
Yes.
What does it mean? That's meaning number 1. That's meaning number 2. Another meaning of discipline. Because when your father complained, when the teacher complained, students in the class, there's no discipline. They have no discipline. They are very noisy. They don't listen to the teacher. They play with the phone. They are Facebooking while I'm teaching. No discipline. So that's the first meaning. Discipline means following the rules. What is the second meaning of discipline? Subjects. The major subject. Okay? So when we deal with the academia, academic context, like when you are talking about universities, when you are dealing with professors, okay, they use the word discipline to refer to the major subject. So they ask you, what is your discipline? And you say, I'm a linguist. I'm from YUFL. I'm a linguist, language expert. I'm an engineer. I'm a medical student. Right? I'm from marketing department. Okay. So, in writing, depending on your major subject, the style of writing, academic writing, varies, there changes a bit. Okay? So, this topic is to focus on that one. Okay. 5. Can you recognize the variations, different styles?
Yes.
So, on this page, there's one box, one abstract. Yeah? On the next page, you will see another 2. I'm going to give you another 5 minutes to read these three abstracts